we are, how far do you think we are from Chicago?
About
100 miles outside of Chicago. Pretty much a standstill. It says only 12 more minutes, but we'll find out. We are on our way to Haydays. So I got Michael here and Tommy with me. We're renting a camper, staying at Racer's Edge, which is like across the street. And we're probably gonna stop about halfway there, maybe a little bit further tonight, and then get a hotel, make the rest of the drive tomorrow. Camper won't be there till like noonish. And we'll start getting everything set up. Hopefully we can get all that done, so then Friday we can kind of do whatever we want. So yeah, we're pretty excited. We've been looking forward to this show for a couple of months now, so should be a pretty good time. We got a trailer full of inventory, gear wrench stuff, DeWalt stuff, flashlights, headlamps, tools, anything you can name it. And then I got my sled and my snow bike with me, so should be a pretty good time. Weather's gonna be perfect. It's like 80 something now, and I think they're calling for like highs of like 71 the next, or for the weekend, so it should be pretty awesome, and we're looking forward to it. So it's like 40 mile an hour wind gusts is what the weather's saying, and we have a really shitty tent. Highly not recommended. I mean, I kind of knew that, but here we are. So we tried to put the top on, and then the tent flew up almost over the trailer, so we took the top off and we were wrestling with it for a while. So we pretty much got what we could out. Inventory and other stuff still in the trailer. Our camper doesn't show up till Racer's Edge, which is that way, until 5 o'clock. So we're probably gonna run into town, get some more steaks for the two tents we brought, and then grab some food and kill some time, because we can't really do anything with this wind. And we can't put inventory out till Saturday, really. So, yeah, they're saying wind should die down tonight. It's like 77-ish right now. It's pretty warm, but the wind's going, so it feels good. And then Saturday and Sunday, the high's like 71, I think, which is awesome. Great kickoff to winter. So we're in a really good spot. We got the Free Rider Films guys over here. I'm sure you've seen their YouTube channel. Pretty badass. And then right here in this spot where my truck is, I think all the way to that tree is Sober Turbos. So I think his name's Kyle. Kyle will be here with all his sweet stuff. But it's filling up pretty quick. We got some pretty badass trucks around here and pretty sweet trailers and some tents that are a hell of a lot nicer than the one we got. So yeah, we'll catch you guys later. There's a $100,000 truck. So we just stopped at the B&M Fab booth. We kind of loaded the trailer a little quickly and we screwed up the golf cart wheels. Tom's crying, you can see. They're brand new. And I threw a bunch of boxes on my sled without the cover, thinking like, all right, it's a cardboard box. And I wore through the powder coat on my brand new bumper. So I stopped at the B&M Fab booth and they hooked me up with a handlebar for the rear bumper. If you're looking for rear bumpers, definitely hit them up. Best on the market without a question. If you've seen any of my videos, you know I total snowmobiles. And the only bumpers I've ever pulled off a sled that I've totaled that weren't also totaled were theirs. So 100% worth the money, highly recommended. But we're just cruising around right now before we go into town, checking out how big this place is. And it is massive. Sober Turbos just got here.
Kyle's setting his stuff up. Pretty wild sleds for sure. But we're coming along. We got shirts hung up. Replacing that bumper handle here. Nice, pretty new one. Got the generator going with the lights on.
The smoker, we got tipped off to start that tonight. Otherwise, it never is done in time. So we're probably going to do that. But
we got lights inside the tent, and then you can't see it, but there's a little rope light from last night that goes around. But
it's coming along. Still raining off and on. Hopefully that stops. I don't know what time it is. I think they said after three. Yeah. Sometime after three, so that'll be good. Because tonight's supposed to be the fun night. Obviously, we don't want to miss that. So, yeah, it's coming along well.
What do you think? Oh, dude, I just about whacked my head on the corner.
I got this ceramic coated last week from Spotless Detailing
out of Van Buren. They did a phenomenal job. Thank God, too, because it is absolutely right now. It is a mess.
So we'll see how it cleans up. I'm sure it'll be great. We were like one of the first probably 15 spots up here
along the road. And now they're like, yeah, you can't hardly see, but there's some up there. This dude's rolling in a school bus.
So we're staying at Racer's Edge. I don't remember if I said that yesterday.
It's literally,
I think the highway, is it 95 you cross?
Yeah.
You cross 95 like right out of the exit from where they let vendors in, and it's probably, I don't know, a couple hundred yards down the street. It's pretty simple. A little cruise on a golf cart or a side-by-side or whatever you got. I think it's like $40 a night if I remember, something like that. Not too bad.
Oh, there's a track side by side.
That'd be sweet. Just like that, pretty simple.
Thanks, guys. Okay. Have a good time.
What was he saying? I think he said you can't ride it in or out. Bullshit.
So since we rolled in yesterday, this place is
absolutely filled up with people. Stuff going on everywhere.
Wanna be the person that you call up when you're down. Wanna be the first who knows all of your deepest secrets. Can I be the one who wakes you up before you miss your ride? 'Cause I wanna be close to you, and I wanna show you something new. You gotta know, every day I got your back, yeah, you can count on me for that.
Yeah. So they're dropping a new sled tomorrow.
I bet dollars it's in that.
Yesterday when we were walking around,
it's called a Widescape. They're out of Canada, and it's got, I think he said it's got like a 250 motor in it. Top end's like 50 mile an hour ish, a little bit less.
But you stand on the back. Here, good. You stand on the back like you would. I don't even know what. Like you were standing on your snowmobile. Your feet are a little closer together. But they weigh like 200 pounds, which is crazy. Like you can literally damn near pick it up with one arm. But he said there's not a huge presence in the US yet. They haven't done a lot of marketing, but it's coming really soon. And this is their first Haydays with that product. But I think he said, didn't he say like 5,000 units a month or something?
Yes.
But or was it 50?
5,000 units a month, but they are getting their own line. So they should be producing even more.
So he said, I think it was Snow Tracks did a video with them last winter. And the guy was like real hesitant about them. Like, I don't know, probably not for me. He was a bigger guy about my size. And I guess he loved them. So I think there's a video on YouTube about those. They look pretty cool. They're kind of comfortable to stand on. Looks like a stand-up jet ski on tracks. So those could be pretty cool seeing soon. And he said, like, I think he said they're looking to get them on trails in like 2 years, they'll be trail legal. So that's also something interesting. Starting price was like $7,000, which if you're trying to get into a sport like that and want something that doesn't take up room, I mean, if you're sled shopping, you know, $7,000 doesn't get you a whole lot. So, yeah. So we kind of worked our way out of the
vendor spot back that way. And now,
I mean, there's still quite a bit of vendors on in this main area, but
it's all swap meet. Pretty crazy.
Put your hand in mine, I will be there every day when you're sick.
thing I've noticed that surprised me the most. One, obviously the size. Like, you see the annual, like, magazine articles and stuff about it in a couple videos, but it doesn't, like, you can't fathom how big this area is. He said one of the Snow Barons members was talking to us. He said they have 148 acres here, and, like, damn near all of it is people selling stuff. It's crazy. But the second thing is the newer sleds. Like, back home, all those swap meets are, like, if you see something that's, like, a 2007, that's, like, a new sled there. And here, they've got everything. They got old classics to sleds that are a year old, if that. So
definitely get to see a lot of everything.
We got product testing going on. There's a crew that just showed up to set their stuff up, and it's pretty dark out, so we got our DeWalt spotlight on them.
We got some chicken wings on the smoker coming along nicely.
Right out of Columbus, Ohio, those chicken wings are.
Just chilling now.
Something new. You gotta know, every day I got your back. Yeah, you can count on me.
Should be. Come on, little lady, give us a smile. No, I ain't got nothing to smile about. I've got no one to smile for. I waited a while for a moment to say I don't owe you a goddamn thing. Keep the record.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey,
it's like 11:30. We started off pretty slow, but it is, it's picked up quite a bit. We're getting pretty consistent. Sunday morning, almost 7. Freaking tired, man. But last night was a lot of fun. We're loading the truck now because they're gonna come grab the camper probably around lunch. And then we'll load up the trailer. Gets breakfast. It's very good.
This was my my purchase of the trip.
Onto a new home. What time is it? 5 o'clock?
5:30. It is 5:30. We are packed up. Last one's in our row pretty much. Place clears out pretty quickly. So
we got 11 hours to get home. Probably gonna drive till like 10:30, maybe, if that. And we'll get up and finish the drive tomorrow. Didn't sell as much as we were hoping. I think we did around $5,000 in sales, which is about half of what we did in Michigan last year. But with that being said, we also met a lot more business owners at this Heyday show. And I think that networking and marketing alone is going to pay for any expense we had with this trip. So we'll see over the next couple weeks and months if things like that pan out. We got some samples of soap to some guys in the industry that you've seen their videos before if you watch YouTube videos sledding related. So hopefully we get our stuff in their shops. They tell their riding buddies and we kind of go from there. But definitely a good show. Our best seller once again was those snowmobile kits. So if you're looking for a kit to carry on your sled, throw in your boat, side by side, backseat of your truck, whatever, I'll put a link below of our website. You can buy them on there. And I might do a promo code too. If I do, I'll include that in the bottom. At least get you guys free shipping if you want the kit. So thanks for watching. Highly recommend Haydays. Beautiful weather outside of Friday when it rained all day. And like I said, this place is massive. If you've never seen it, 100% recommend. Loads and loads of fun. And honestly, you don't even have to like snowmobiles. I mean, there's so much to do and so many different things to see. Power sports related, and not, especially on the swap side. So highly recommend it. Definitely check it out. Thanks for watching. So it's Tuesday. It's after lunch, but we're working on unloading the trailer. We opened it up this morning. I'm like, man, it smells like two stroke smoke. And like, we loaded the sled and it got smoky, but I mean, that was a while ago. We get the boxes off in front of the golf cart.
There's oil all over the ground and skid marks. And we see the golf cart belt. You can see it out there laying underneath the golf cart. We had a tool kit up here and it rolled off. And Tommy didn't shut the key off all the way on the golf cart and hit the gas pedal. And it was just, the clutch on that thing's toasted. You rotated it and there's pieces, you can hear it. But we got lucky, this thing could have caught fire. But yeah, there's
I swear, eventful morning so far.